Let's talk about how to get involved in research as a high school student. If you're a scientifically minded high schooler looking ahead to your college applications, you've probably heard that getting involved in research is one of the best ways you can boost your extracurricular profile. After all, gaining experience in a real lab is invaluable training that you simply can't get through a textbook or most high school science courses. That's why research is a next level extracurricular that will give you a real leg up in the admissions process. On the flip side, you might be wondering, do high school students really do research, or is that an admissions myth? How might you realistically find a foothold in actual scientific research when you don't have any experience? The short answer is yes, high school students do get involved in research, and yes, it's possible for you to be one of them. Hi, I'm Dr. Shemmassian, college admissions expert at Shemmassian Academic Consulting. In this video, I'll talk about the ins and outs of getting involved with research as a high school student, including why you might want to gain research experience, different types of experiences you could participate in, and how to find and navigate those opportunities. Let's get started. There are a number of reasons you might want to get involved with research as a high school student. As I mentioned earlier, research will provide you with real experience that goes beyond what you're likely to learn in the scope of your high school science curriculum. So not only will research advance your scientific education, it'll also reflect well on your enthusiasm for the field and your ambitions to work at the highest level possible. Research also typically involves a substantial, sustained time commitment that will demonstrate you possess dedication and maturity. It also usually helps develop skills that admissions committees see as generally positive for your academic career, such as independence and confidence in your own work. Plus, it can lay the groundwork for further accomplishments, such as your own research projects, advanced research in college, or even journal publications. All of these outcomes can help make you a more attractive candidate for college admissions. There are two main reasons why you might not want to get involved with research as a high school student. The first has to do with the substantial time commitment I talked about earlier. If you're consumed with other extracurriculars that you're very serious about, or maybe you have a part-time job or family obligations, realistically you might not have enough free time to seriously commit to a research position while also going to high school. Most ongoing positions will require you to dedicate at least 5 hours per week, spread out over a few different days. So think carefully about whether or not that's feasible for you. You don't want to go through all the trouble of lining up a position that you can't give your all to. However, if you are too busy during the school year, there are other options that you can pursue over the summer, which I'll talk about shortly. The other reason to be cautious about getting involved with research is somewhat related. Just as you don't want to overextend your schedule, you also don't want to spread your extracurricular focus too wide. Here at Shemmassian, we usually recommend that students aim to be known as specialists, who excel in one or two particular areas, rather than spread their extracurricular energies far and wide. This strategy gives applicants the best chance of standing out in their college application. Say you want to be known as a specialist in environmental science and you're already involved with related activities, like volunteering for a conservation nonprofit and organizing beach cleanups. So long as you have the time, scientific research is an activity that would dovetail well with that extracurricular profile. On the other hand, if you're already devoted to editing the school newspaper and playing first chair violin, adding research to your plate might reduce your chances of truly shining in any of those areas. Here's the bottom line. Take the time to carefully evaluate what you want to focus on and whether you have the time to seriously invest in doing research. As a high school student, you can pursue research experiences in two different ways. The first way is to seek out a research assistant position in your area. This means working at a university, research hospital, or independent lab local to you. An advantage of working close to home is that you'll have the opportunity to put sustained effort into your work, since typically your position will last at least 6 weeks. In some cases, it might even last an entire school year or more. Not only does this give you the chance to seriously contribute to a lab's projects, it also increases the likelihood that you'll build real relationships with mentors from your lab. As a research assistant, you might work for free in exchange for the experience, similar to an internship. If that's the case, you should expect to be at least somewhat involved in hands-on research. It's a good idea to make sure you understand what the position involves before signing on and that it aligns with your expectations. Obtaining a research assistant position can be tricky and usually involves a lot of cold calling or emailing, unless you happen to have personal connections. We'll talk more about how to do this later in the video, but in short, it's usually much more involved than filling out an application. Speaking of applications, that brings us to your other main option, applying for formal research programs, which typically occur over the summer. Most of these programs are several weeks long and intensive, so they usually take up the majority of your summer. Some summer research programs are residential, meaning you'll spend much of the summer away from home, typically living on a college campus. Others are day programs, which will require you to live or have a place to stay near the host institution. Summer programs are frequently run by universities or at least set on their campuses, though it's also fairly common that they're put on by independent research institutes or hospitals, particularly in the case of programs focused on medical research. The good news about all of these programs is that they tend to offer intensive hands-on experiences, plus extra opportunities such as lectures, field trips, and professional development workshops that you probably won't get as a research assistant at your local university. There's little chance that you'll be spending a lot of time sweeping the floor or washing petri dishes here. And unlike a research assistant position where you might be the only high school student in the lab, in a formal program, you're likely to be with a group of your peers who are as passionate about science as you are. The bad news is that many of these programs are extremely selective, and some of them are also quite expensive, costing as much as $6,000 or $7,000 for the summer. Many of the most prestigious programs tend to be free, but as you might suspect, these are usually the most competitive ones to get into, so you'll likely need to demonstrate impressive academic talent to be in the running. If you're interested in applying to formal summer programs, I recommend reading our guide on the best summer programs for high school students, which includes several scientific research programs like Research Science Institute, Minority Introduction to Engineering and Science, Girls Who Code Summer Immersion Programs, Stanford University Mathematics Camp, and Research in Science and Engineering Program. Link in the comments box below. This post only covers residential programs and is focused on highly prestigious and selective experiences, so it isn't all-encompassing. However, a quick Google search will turn up other programs to choose from. If you're interested in day programs, it's a good idea to check the websites of universities, hospitals, or research institutes near you to see if they offer formal research opportunities over the summer. Next, let's talk about how to find informal research assistant positions in your local area. Before we get started, I want to note that if your local institution does have a formal research program geared towards high schoolers, we recommend starting there instead of trying to arrange a position outside of the program. Now that we have that out of the way, the first step in finding a research position is to draw on any personal connections you might have at local universities, research hospitals, or labs. If you have family members, family, friends, mentors, or teachers who have any contacts at those institutions, ask them if they'd be willing to put you in touch with that person. Even if it doesn't necessarily pan out, a personal introduction can often lead to being put in contact with a more appropriate employee. And don't worry if you don't have any personal connections to draw on. It just means that you'll need to cold call or cold email researchers. Begin by browsing the websites of universities or labs in your area, focusing on the specific departments and areas of research that speak to your interests. Identify and make a list of any researchers who seem like potentially viable mentors. Keep in mind that at a university, a researcher might be a faculty member, but they could also be a visiting scholar, postdoctoral fellow, or even a graduate student. Once you have your list, send inquiry emails to your top 5 to 10 choices. Email is perfect in this situation instead of a phone call because it's unobtrusive and allows the person to respond on their own timeline. I'll go over the basics of what you should include in your email in just a moment. You might get lucky and hear back from one of your first inquiries, but you should also be prepared not to receive any responses. That's why it's helpful to send multiple inquiries. Remember that researchers are usually extremely busy people, so you shouldn't be discouraged or offended if they don't write back to you. You might consider sending a follow-up email after a few weeks if you haven't received a response, but definitely do not do this more than once. After a week has gone by, send out a new batch of emails to 5 to 10 more researchers and repeat this process every week until you find someone willing to take you on. Keep in mind that you might need to contact a lot of people before you're able to successfully make a connection. 30 or even 50 tries aren't uncommon. So it's a good idea to give yourself a lot of time before you want to start researching. Now let's talk about how to write an inquiry email. Send a professional, polite email that addresses the researcher by their title. For instance, Dear Professor Sasaki or Dear Dr. Washington. Then include the following. A short introduction to who you are, such as your name, grade, and where you attend high school. What research areas and types of projects you're interested in and why. Your enthusiasm to learn from the person you're writing to and an interest in their work. a willingness to fill whatever role they have available, emphasizing that you can work on a volunteer basis. Your availability, which should be maximally flexible, including specific days of the week and hours you're available, the duration you can work for example, the summer, fall, semester, or the entire school year, an expression of gratitude for their time, your contact information, and your CV or resume as an attachment. Here's an example. Dear Dr. Barnes, I hope this message finds you well. My name is Shirak Shemmassian and I'm a junior at Westlake High School. I came across your research profile on the UCLA website and admire the various contributions you've made to the field of school psychology. In my first 2 years of high school, I volunteered at a local preschool and became interested in learning how educators can support immigrant children transitioning to a foreign language learning environment. I'm writing to ask if there's anything I can do to assist you with your current research project since you have expertise in this area. I am available 10 hours per week and would welcome any opportunity to get involved and learn from you. Thank you for your time and consideration. Best, Shirak Shemmassian. This might sound like a lot of information, but you can actually keep it fairly simple. Remember that researchers are busy, so they don't want to read long emails. Instead, aim to write a few concise, polished paragraphs. Before you send the email, triple check to ensure that the info in the email matches the person you're sending it to, especially if you copied and pasted any part of the email. Getting involved with research as a high school student is a great way to gain invaluable experience that will boost your extracurricular profile for college admissions. First, make sure that you have the time and energy to devote to research, and consider what kinds of research opportunities appeal to you most. Then you can embark on either summer program applications or the process of reaching out to researchers in your local area. While these processes can be involved, remember that the payoff will allow you to explore your love of science and will set you apart from the pack come application time. If you found this video helpful, go ahead and hit the like button. And if you haven't subscribed to our channel yet, you can do that here so you don't miss out on new videos. You can also learn how to maximize your odds of admission at competitive colleges by clicking the link in the description below. Our free guide, How to Get into America's Elite Colleges, offers strategies to help you get into schools like Harvard, Stanford, and Princeton. All right, thanks so much for watching. See you next time.